unify the two school systems, are we? I mean, please correct me if I'm wrong, but what is before us is a petition by a group of citizens, 7,163 certified. Well, you say they were misled. I'm sorry, Councilman Vickers, but you made some strong accusations against some fine standing people.
I mean, that's what I see about it.
Well, I think you're fine standing people. We may not agree on every issue, but I know these folks, and I'm sure of them.
Please direct all discussion at either myself or the group.
Well, I'm just, you know, I think we should be respectful. So is Reverend Butler, and so is Rusty Griffin, and so is Walter Hobbit, and so is George Bennett, along with a lot of other folks who have served on this board. And it just bothers me when I hear that we're being hoodwinked by these kind of people. But the fact of the matter is, what is before us is a petition by 7,163,000 citizens registered to vote in the city of Mount Hospital, asking us to do place a referendum on the ballot. We're not voting for the ballot tonight. We're just passing along what a group of citizens have petitioned their city to do. And we have legal interpretation that this would be in violation of the Constitution of the State of Georgia. And I take that sort of thing very seriously. Now, as to the issues that both Councilman Wright and Councilman Vickers have brought up in regards to potential flaws in the referendum or the ballot initiative, those are issues that should be decided somewhere other than the city council. But so those are issues that should be decided between the school system and CUE with that court law, not the city of Mount Oscar. I think that's a totally separate issue compared to what's being brought before us. I will not go further into anything other than I will in favor of this because I have citizens that have properly executed a petition that's been certified by the city of Mount Oscar and meets all the requirements based on the state constitution and code, and I will be